further. Because it's devotional service, it becomes, it brings us to the transcendental platform. So abhayam is essential. Otherwise we are habitually in bodily conception of life, always remain fearful. Always remain fearful. Now, fear comes due to attachment. So, pa pa ba ba ma is the alphabets we have to learn right from the beginning. But this pa means parishram, pa means phala, and if you accept it, ba means bandhan, and that is the bondage. And if you are bound, don't blame anybody. You are going to be fearful. You cannot say that devil made me do it. The devil is in within you, and you are, you know, negligent. So, those who are bound naturally will be fearful. They cannot be liberated. So, abhayam is a very important point that is required. Arjun never thought that his grandfather and Drona will be shown to him that they were rushing in the mouth of Virata Rupa. It terrified him. Because he was thinking that, oh, his grandfather is more worshipable. And Dronacharya, his spiritual master, more worshipable. But they have their own devotional service. That is besides the point. But what is Arjun's attachment was not spiritual. Arjun's attachment was not spiritual. Therefore, there was fear, and he didn't like that his superiors should meet this kind of fate, which is horrible. The description of the Virata Rupa chewing them and relishing the bodies of Bhishma and all other great soldiers, they were rushing in the mouth as if Krishna is enjoying. Every mortal being will be terrified when they face death. If they are bodily attached, terrifying situation will be there. And in Garuda Purana, people die in different circumstances, different you know, kinds of fear also arising in them, right? And out of the nine gates, the soul will depart. The departation of those who are on the tamasic vritti, they become so fearful, they pass through and the soul leaves through that gate. It means it's directly going to Yamaraj, the south gate, what they call it. So, the point is that devotional service has to be rendered not out of fear, but one can perform devotional service when the result is joyful. So, where is the question of fear? So, Anya Bilashita Sunyam Jnana Karmadana Putam Anukulena Krishnanashilana Bhaktiruttama. The best way is to perform the devotional service which is very favorable to Lord Krishna, means Krishna asks and you supply it. Krishna says, do this, then you do it. But we think, oh, Krishna is interfering. These religious dogmas are interfering in our desires all the time and make us religious robots. People are there, agnostic people, they do counterattack like this. But Mamupekitu Ponte Lukale Masashwanti Mahatmana Samsiddhi Parmamgata. That is the positive result, and Krishna is always describing everything that is positive to us, nothing negative. Everything is positive. So we have to put that intellectual faith. Why intellectual faith? Faith cannot be generated just like that. By proper association, when the talk on the basis of, say, self-realization, if people are putting forward, then there is an acceptance. So buddhi yoga is bhakti yoga. But we do not use our intelligence, which is the discriminating faculty between sat and asat. We must have a forward fortress of this checker. This is where the discipline begins. Don't become sentimental, don't push forward the sentimental ideas and agendas. They do not belong in ISKCON. Many devotees who are taking great responsibilities, they become careless. We think, oh, they are not sensitive enough. But no, sensitiveness is different than sentimentalism. So nowhere our sentiments are supposed to be, and unless the purified sentiments are there. But before that, we become sentimental. It is mixed modes of material nature. So material nature can make you sentimental, even in mode of goodness. Oh, I didn't mean, but it slipped away from our mouth. Oh, I didn't think I want to hurt you, but you can't absorb the responsibilities. Even a silent witness in the offense of a devotee, like Bhishma Pitama and Dronacharya, both remain silent. They could not tell anything. And Duryodhan was chastising them, even though he is such a subordinate person, that you are eating in my house, my food, and was obliging them to act. But they were devotees. They tolerated such as, insults at such an extent. We can't imagine that anybody, will be able to tolerate this kind of thing in this form. The slightest provocation, there is a great war. Slightest provocation. So what to speak in the material world? But Krishna is not disturbed. In the form of his Virata Rupa and death personified, he keeps on doing a job that is, he is taking great pleasure in wiping out. It's by his desire that wind flows, by his desire, fearing all the material energies are acting. And they have to be in tune. These energies are manifesting the nature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. How do we know? Well, Shweta Satara Upanishad is telling, nacha tasya karanam karanam cha vidyate, nacha tasamasam abhikadhikaccha drashyate, parasya shaktir vividhir sruyate, swabhavikhi jnana balakriyacha. Krishna is that Supreme Personality of Godhead who doesn't have a cause, or nothing can cause him to do anything. And that is the unique position that nobody has become greater or equal to. We simply say, asmordva means asama, means an ordva. Nobody is equal to or superior than him. And that's why his Supreme Personality of Godhead. But what is this? Every other living entity has a cause and karanam, functions to perform. Maybe on behalf of Krishna, directed by Krishna, directly, indirectly, or that is their occupational duty, they receive. But Krishna doesn't have, and that's why he is playing flute. Is the flute is called a forceful activity. In material world, a musician may earn little money on the footpath by playing flute. But Krishna doesn't do anything. He attracts with love and care, but he doesn't give up his position. It's not easy to be sold out to anybody and everybody. So, Sitashatra Upanishad says, that is why nobody is equal to or greater than him. He is the Supreme. And moreover, his potencies are so variegated, they manifest in jnana, bala and kriya. These are the potential manifestation in these three fields. And swabhaviki. Swabhav means they know the nature of the Supreme Absolute, Krishna. So without ordering or even chanting a mantra, you know, Krishna has to release those energies automatically. There is so much harmony, identification with Krishna and his energy, you can't separate them. If you have Radha Krishna deities, make sure they are close together. Prabhupada doesn't like them to be a little separated at a distance, or you put somebody else in between them. No. And similarly to Gornitai. Don't try to separate. Gaur here on the right side, Nitai on the left side. No. Put them together. Krishna wants to be known through Radharani. That is the potency. But otherwise, what is the value without potency? A potent cannot be known. So similarly, Svetashatara Upanishad is telling that there is no single personality except Lord Shri Krishna whose energies are manifesting according to knowing his desires. If the energies are in tune with your desires, then you are Lord and Master. But unfortunately, we are in marginal energy and we sometimes are overpowered by material energy and sometimes spiritual energy. But now it is time, and in practice we have to come out on the side of spiritual energy, because our constitution is spiritual energy. It's not material energy. So then, with all logic and with all persuasion, the spiritual life is always supposed to be the topmost in advancement in our this particular duration of life. Everybody has to go. So material attachment, which is said to be pavarga, that is a path to hell. But tajyoshanavam apavarga vartamani sraddharapi bhakti anukramashita. This is the first instruction Kapil Dev is giving to his mother Devuti. And mother, you should associate with the devotees. Satam prasangam mama vidya samvida bhavanti radhakarna rasayana katha tajyoshanavam apavarga vartamani Shraddha rati bhakti anukramashita. The Shraddha, Shraddha shadde sudrada vishvasa karanishche krashte bhakti karile sarva karma krita ho. Now, adav Shraddha, but it does not define the explanations. It does not go along with the explanation that is said in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Shatadhana, Shabda, this is utilized. Shata means purified. Dha means dhyā. When the intelligence is purified, and if you make a resolve through intelligence and deliberation, that should be Shraddha. But coming in association with the devotees, Adav Shraddha, we develop the faith, but we do not know the purification of the faith. So again, go back to the association of the devotees. Tato sadhu sangha. Then perform bhajana kriya and anartha nivritti shya. We discuss anartha nivritti in the morning. So the process has been delineated according to the divine target, that somehow or other we have to connect, even though if we do not know. But ignorance is not excuse. And those who are preachers, they must be equipped with this knowledge. Otherwise, how are they going to be able to preach? We are not giving lip service. We need to, instill in the associations the requisite faith. Requisite. So, satam prasangam mamatirya samvidha bhavanti radhakarana rasayana katha, that you receive this, the rasayana means nectarian descriptions, which will be purifying our heart, but it has to be administered to the ear and enter into the heart. So, bhavanti radha karana rasayana tad yoshanavam apavargavu, that will open the path to liberation. And then requisite faith, shraddha, rati, attraction, and bhakti, three will manifest. It's not out of this, how much are we attracted? Rati is there, that is a questionable thing. And how much bhakti is there? You can't put up limits. Akarshan to the process should be there, because the process is perfect. I may be imperfect. That is the rule. So, in the same way, visualization of the manifested energies, that was but natural inquisitiveness of Arjuna. So in the 10th chapter and 7th chapter also, Krishna describes his manifested material energies. But Krishna is not so happy to describe in details. He already said, oh, why do you have to know so much? Just know that Vistabhyam Aham Krishnam Ekaushena Jagatasthitas. I am all pervading simply by a fragment of my portion. Because Krishna's vibhuti means vibhus, manifested material energy is called vibhuti. Krishna's vibhuti are immeasurable. Everything is attractive. But we think this is it. We do not know the game changer or game player is behind the scene. Because he is not material in nature. He has to cover himself in the curtail of Maya. Aham prakasa sarvasya yoga maya samavutam. I'm keeping myself always covered. But Arjun was having direct reciprocation with Krishna, and still he has some misunderstandings about the aspect of the Supreme Personality of Godhead because of bodily conception. But he corrects it. He begs forgiveness. He had no motivation to displease his friend because he is confused, and he resorted to Lord Krishna for proper guidance. So Krishna heavily agreed to it. And at the same time, understanding this different manifested energy, there is an automatic desire. Just like curiosity kills the cat. So he became curious to see manifested all this material energy in one place, in his embodiment, just to make sure that Krishna is right at the same time he will personally experience it. But to his desire, personal experience is also becoming threatening to him. Otherwise, theoretically, or by study and following in the footsteps of predecessor acharyas, Arjuna is accepting in 10th chapter itself the absoluteness of Lord Sri Krishna. Param Brahma, Param Dhamam, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan, Purusham, Shashvatam, Divyam, Adi, Devam, Ajam, Vidhum, Ahustvam Rushaya Sarva Devarsi Narvadastatha Asito Devalo Vyaswa Swayam Chaiva Brahmishime The Sarva Meta Dhritam Manye. I accept this as factual. As factual, not virtual. He said factual. Because you yourself are cooperating with all the great saints. You are the Supreme Personality. So I accept it. So that is theoretical aspect. Then he desired that all these opulences that you are describing, and you say that it is all pervading within a fraction of my existence. So naturally, another inquisitiveness for the cat. Show me that form. And Krishna showed that appropriate form. And he completely lost composure. He was so much terrified. In terrified situation, you are not going to get confused. It's because you have lost all the intelligence. That's why the terror or other things are so happening. That they don't mistreat you, just shoot you. That's all. So terror is the last weapon. So Arjuna was terrified. And seeing this situation, Arjuna admits everything that is possible for him to surrender totally. And, my dear Lord, you are not ordinary. He accepts. He begs forgiveness. Otherwise, he didn't commit any crime. It is only the misunderstanding. He did not commit a crime. He begs forgiveness of all the bodily connections. Please. Now I understand. So I cannot treat you the way I was treating you before. But that doesn't mean Krishna discontinued or Arjuna discontinued his friendship. It was difficult for Arjuna to stay without Krishna. So therefore he frequented to Dwarka just to see. Any pretext, he will go. So here, in a terrified condition, the devotee comes to his senses. He accepts and admits without any doubt. So there are no doubtful questions are ever asked after this personal experience of Virata Rupa. And Krishna was very kind, seeing his friend and now on a different level of communication was there. And even Krishna did not like this terrified condition of his friend. But obviously, Arjuna being subordinate and as a shishya, he begs not only forgiveness, but tells him to return. So, Lord Krishna is showing him 400 forms of Vishnu. It is too difficult to interact with for Arjuna. Understand, in Dwarka, the Lord is having 400 forms. Right? When Arjuna goes, he interacts with only 200 forms. Arjuna is interacting with Krishna only with 200 forms. But, all the Yadavas and others, they understand his 400 form. So, in Jagannath Puri, which is equivalent on Dwarka platform, even all the residents of Jagannath Puri are having 400 form. That is the vision of Sanatana Goswami. If you read in Bhagavatam, it's all in reverence. But he is a friend. Fraternity is beyond awe and reverence and even servitorship. So it was a deeper sentiment, and these sentiments are not material sentiments conducted by the three modes. But these are spiritual sentiments. Interaction in the spiritual world is more important. So here, Krishna is standing in the Virat form. So Arjuna is requesting, I cannot interact with this form. You are our savior, we have surrendered to you. Krishna is taking care of even Bhishma Pitamaha and Dronacharya. They were vessels, and they were in service of Lord Vishnu. Therefore, Bhishma Pitama asked Krishna to show his 400 form before he died. And Krishna did it. But Arjun was not perplexed at that time, because he already saw 400 Vishnu form, but he was not able to reciprocate with him. So he demands his Saumya Vapu, Saumya Vapu, beautifully, and decorated 200 form. So this particular verse is telling, Mate Gatita. Mate Vyatha Mata Vimutabhavo Drashtva Rupam Goram Vidam Mahmai Vedam Vyapeta Bhi Pritamana Punastvam Tadevame Rupam Idam Prapashya. Pritamana means pleasing. Right. So Krishna is telling, you have been perturbed and bewildered by seeing this horrible feature of mine that is Virata Rupa. Now let it be finished. My devotee, be free again from all disturbances. With a peaceful mind you can now see the form you desire. So it will be Samya Vapu. So that has been told by Sanjay in description in the next verse. So we need to look into and how Arjun is also reciprocating with Sanjay's description. Arjun was drashtedam manusam rupam. Manusam rupam. Manushim tanumashritam, manushum rupam means human-like, not human form, but human-like form. That he may be looking like one of us, but he is not one of us. Our body is made up of three modes of material nature, and all are some products of earth, water, fire, air, ether. Mind, intelligence, and ego. All the eight compositions are within the body. Three are subtle, five are gross. Krishna doesn't have that. This constitution, even Janak Maharaj didn't have. By pure devotional service, he transformed his entire constitution of the body and the spiritual one. So he went back home, back to Godhead, in the self-same body. It looks like human body, but purified existence is keeping the same shape, but it is all Satchidananda Rupam. Ishvara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vidraha Anadi Radir Govinda Sarvakarana Karana. His constitution is made up of Satchidananda. These are the three transcendental modes in spiritual. But the spiritual energy is also three: Sandini, Samvit, and Ladini Shakti. Alright? So, Shakti must be contained by the gunas of the modes. Our Shakti of earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and ego is Prakriti Ashtadha, but it is captured or bound up with a form of goodness, passion, or ignorance, or mixed modes. Generally, we have more of passion, more and therefore we become hyperactive. Krishna is not like that. He is well balanced in his what they call the status of Vishuddha Sattva. And that existence he never gives up. He never falls down or comes down to material platform. If he comes, he will come on his self-same body. That's the climax. Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj, Devaki and Vasudeva. Both the couples wanted the original form of the Lord to perform childhood pastimes. That's the desire. But they appeared before them because Vasudeva purified himself and Vishuddha Sattva level. So Krishna can enter in his heart. And Vasudeva initiated Devaki and make Krishna as it is situated in her heart. But the demigods change the whole scenario. Oh, she is becoming so effulgent. Surely now Krishna, because the time is there, he must have entered in her womb. And so they came on and praying her good fortune. But everybody is surprised when no crying of child has ever come and Krishna appeared first in 400 Vishnu form. Rupa Goswami says when Krishna descended, all his expansions are embedded in him. All the Vishnu. Karnodakshaya Vishnu, Garbhadakshaya Vishnu, Kshirodakshaya Vishnu, who expands as Paramatma, everyone was with him. So can you imagine the potency of sum total of Godhood is there? Nobody can compete. So he is a Samurtha. And the original form, Prabhupada says, is 200 form. We are made in image of God, but image is always perverted. We can transform the qualitativeness of our being, getting free from the effects of the 3 modes of material nature, thereby declaring our eternity, and the functionality in the eternity is pure devotional service. So these are all the boundaries we have to cross. So never be afraid. Krishna is not fearful for the demons. Remember when you sang the Nashinkavaj yesterday, I told you that Madhvacharya is telling that Ugropyanu Evayam Bhaktanam Rakeshari Kesari Swakotanam Annesham Ugravikramaha. Meaning is that Madhvacharya is glorifying Lord Nrisimhadeva, that you are ferocious. Just like a lion is also ferocious. The mouth of lioness is ferocious and death personified for a prey. But Kesari Swapodanam, the lioness, she has cubs, her own. And they also are being picked up by the same ferocious mouth. But they never feel afraid of that mouth. Right? Have you seen a cat even pick up the kittens in her mouth and place it somewhere else? Or are they going to be hurt? They never feel hurt. So this is the closeness Lord Narsingadev is so much, I mean, reciprocated by the kids more than even adults. Kids love Narsingadev. They are not afraid. So fear is the cause. We have different types of fears, but simply in association of the devotees, even where the talks of the Supreme Absolute are, the potency will enter in our heart and we will be properly situated in for the performance of devotional service. That's anybody has any question?
I have question.
You have?
I have two questions.
You have a mic? I have put up hearing aids.
Okay.
Now I was avoiding because they were not charged. Okay.
My first question is that when Dushasan, Vasrohan, Draupadi, and there is all the super fighters sitting down there, like Bhishma Dev, Dronachari, Kripachari, even Dhritarashtra, he's a king himself, his father.
But he was blind.
I know.
He was spiritually blind also.
But they are all of them completely, they're silent. They didn't say any word. Head down, they didn't say any word even. That's the first one. And second one is that Draupadi have five husbands. Is it the five is one or they are individual?
Draupadi has five?
Draupadi have five husbands, right?
Uh-huh.
So is there five or one like expansion or is that the individual?
No, there were five individuals. But unity between them was more important. If a man can have multiple wives, why not a wife can have multiple husbands?
Mm-hmm.
Now, she was married to the virtues of this five husbands.
Okay.
And you can't compare with the Kali Yuga vices to have five wives. These vices have increased to number 72 wives if you die for Allah. Right? 72 huras will be. You'll be enjoying. This is such a hype, and you can't comment on that because they will become violent.
Yeah.
And they will say, "Oh, you are defaming our Allah." Sartan sejda. Actually, they are also there because to keep the balance between. For the population to wipe out. Krishna has multiple ways to, you know, keep the balance.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody is playing their role. If we are firmly situated in Krishna consciousness, then everything will be very, very happy. But yeah, the troubles are going to come, but we don't put up, you know, emergencies, measures. We do not have. We know only three things: chant, dance, and take Krishna prasad.
Hare Krishna.
Yes. As long as these things are carried on, then no miseries. Miseries are only given to material attachment. That's all. Finished. Okay. Yeah.
All right. You were talking about Arjuna, how he was so close to Krishna. And when he went to Dwarka, Krishna would, he would associate with Krishna in a two-arm form. And that was his relationship all along. And why, in the 11th chapter, why does Arjuna ask to see a four-arm form? Like, why would he do that?
Now, this was before he went to Dwarka. This is during the time of Kurukshetra War.
Right.
While he came to Hastinapur just for to be on the side of Pandavas. When the problem started, he was there. And he ended the problem. And after that, giving them victory, he is going back to Dwarka. So the incident of Arjuna visiting Dwarka is after that, not before. So after Kurukshetra War, Jarasandha came 17 times, but he was defeated by Krishna. Right? On the 18th time, under the pretext of killing Kala Yavan, he left the battlefield. So Jarasandha was very popular. Look, he got fearful. Okay, I'll send Kala Yavan to chase him. He's a coward. But devotees celebrate. Run Chhoda Raya Ki
Jai.
That temple is in Gujarat. Visit that.
Maharaj, you were talking about Svetashvatara Upanishad, Jnana, Bala, Kriya, the three energies. How are they related to Sandini, Samvit and Haradini? Is there a relationship between
them? Sandini Shakti is existential energy. Balaram is the chief custodian. Samvit is Saraswati. She is always in the heart of Lord Krishna. And Ladini is Ravakarani. And Tulsi Maharani is combination of Samvit and Ladini Shakti. Manifest. So, Jnana, about devotional service, must be there. You cannot perform devotional service without proper education. It's not like mana changa to katharota me ganga. Kehte na. In Hindi, there is a proverb. If your mind is good, then Krishna is right in your pocket. Our mind is turbulent. Has anybody captured his mind? But the way to capture mind and control mind is chant Hare Krishna. So people, they are sentimental idiots. They only worship Krishna and not Radharani. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, give up that company. He is not a Krishna Bhakta. If somebody defames or does not give any credence to the Shakti Tattva, of Lord Sri Krishna, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, give up his company, do not associate with this rascal. So Shakti Tattva, spiritual Shakti Tattva, is Jnana and Bhakti. So Saraswati Devi is Samvit Shakti that liberates one, removes you. And Krishna says, Tesham satata yuktanam bhajatam prati purvakam dadami buddhi yogam tam yena. Krishna gives sufficient intelligence, knowledge, by which he can come to me. But we have to satata yuktanam. Our efforts should be continuous. We can't give up. So three energies, when they are bound by three gunas, spiritual gunas, they become manifested in personality. Material energy and material gunas, they give jatna, 8.4 million species of life. That permutation and combination of the three modes, 3 into 3 is equal to 9, 9 is 9 is equal to 81. Unlimited forms in different computation and permutation. That is Brahma's job. That is Visarga. So similarly, in spiritual world, spiritual manifestation is also there with a spiritual energy bound up by spiritual gunas. Satchitananda. Impersonalists do not have any faith in the energies and gunas. Any other question?
Hello.
Just one question. Most of the temples in South India, they only
worship
Radha
Narayan.
Why is that?
Most
of the temples in South India.
In South India, generally they worship Lakshmi Narayan by the verdict of Ramanujacharya. Ramanuja Sampradaya, most of the temples they worship Lakshmi Narayan.
But in Udipi, only Krishna is there. In Guruvayi temple, Krishna is there.
Oh, because this is the leftover of Rukmini Devi's deity. You know, after sinking in Dwarka, you know, it came under clay, Gopichanda. But one merchant was using it as an anchor in his boat.
But why they still worship
Udipi
and Krishna?
Because they received only a young child Krishna. Where interactions, yes, Guru Vayur also, like Guru and Vayu, Brahaspati and Vayu Devata, they picked up another murti and they were looking for a special place. So they came where Bindu Sarovar is there, and Mahadev was there. So they requested Lord Shiva, that, can you please help us to find a suitable place? This is Rukmini's deity. If Rukmini is worshipping Krishna, do you require another expansion? That is Lakshmi Narayan.
During the temple you don't see that.
Yeah, but Guru and Rupa is 400. And Rukmini was worshipping that deity, alright, in 200 form. So they have, even though they are Mayavadi, Shankarites who are worshipping, but Krishna is engaging them to worship in 200 form. 400 form is never worshipped. They hide other two hands and make Krishna dance on Kaliya, but that is all Chandan, every time they use. And only Krishna is there. But Rukmini is worshipping. So do you need?
My point, we don't see that figure in
the eye. Right. But at the same time, they cannot change the idea. If Rukmini is there, they are worshipping Krishna on behalf of Rukmini. Rukmini is Lakshmi personified, expansion of Radharani.
Which sampradaya do they belong to, those two temples? Huh? Which sampradaya do they belong to, those two
temples? No sampradaya. They are Mayavadi. Jagannath is worshipped by Mayavadis, Sabaras, aborigines.
So, you should be visiting those temples or not?
No. If you see, that tilaks are different.
I'm a pleasure, but should we go and visit those temples and associate with
them? Baba, Krishna has given good lesson to Yamunacharya or
Ramanujacharya.
Yeah, he went to Jagannath Puri and he was kicked out. He fell back into fell back. I accept any service from anybody. That is my desire. Who are you to interfere? But in another situation, if you say, Srinathji deity, I installed because it is Madhvendrapuri's deity. He found out. And the tradition is that Srimati Radharani is also worshipped by three articles of her Shringar. Srinathji has Namani, Nathani, and Shikha. Three things. Even Radharan has only single deity, but they worship the paraphernalia of Radharani. They are called Radharama, and he's only Raman there, not Radha. But even Bhakti Bihari.
But they say Radha in Bhakti Bihari, Radharani in the Vigra itself, so they're combined.
Not combined. They are putting also Radharani's paraphernalia. The crown, the ordini, and all this.
The Haridas who asked for him to come in, Krishna and the form. Radha Krishna together, but then
they are deep into Radha, Radha Seva. Okay? But we are told, if they say Radha Krishna, we say Hare Krishna. We go through the potency, that is our teachings. There's no difference, but still, it is too easy to understand Radharani as a coward girl. And they may tell a lot of stories which are attractive, but they are not purifying. Purifying is, according to this age of Kali, is Hara, Shakti, internal potency. We chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra for that reason. That is Nimbarka Sampradaya. Yugala Nama Sruti Sara He Radhe Krishna Radhe. But they made up, but this is a philosophy. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted two things from Nimbarka Sampradaya, two things from Madhva Sampradaya, also two things from even Ramanuja Sampradaya, and from Rudra Sampradaya, two things. The essential features are there, and everyone, otherwise, they are utilizing the philosophy which starts from Achintya Bheda Vedatattva. Achintya means inconceivable, but simultaneously oneness and difference should be understood. So, our tradition from Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya is our definition of Achintya Bheda Bhakti Tattva, which has been taking all four important important matters that we have to follow.
So, the Radha Krishna method is also one of five men?
No. We chant Hare Krishna.
But
that's okay. No, the methodology of worship of the gopis is accepted from Nimbarka, and existence of Srimati Radharani because in other Puranas are there, it may not be, you know, in Srimad Bhagavatam, but indication is there indirectly by Sukadeva Goswami. So there are deeper sentiments of, you know, spiritual nature are there, and that will be sufficing. That's how there was a challenge to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur in Jaipur court. When they moved Govindji there, Radharani got this, you know, somewhere separated from Krishna, and they brought only Govindji. And they wanted to install Govindji and Radharani and Ramanandis, the offshoots of Ramananda Sampradaya, they objected. And Bhaktivinoda Vidyabhushan was sent by Vishwanath Chakravarti. He was very old and invalid. He said, "You go." And Baldev defeated them by proper. But then they wanted a written anthology on the Vedanta Sutra, according to, if we want to establish our Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya, you know, then we have to present that treatise. And Srila Prabhupada dedicated Bhagavad Gita to Bhagavad Gita to write. It's written here. So Srila Valde Vidyabhushan, who presented so nicely the Govinda Bhashya commentary on Vedanta philosophy. That is the tradition. So we stand our own foot. And Prabhupada, by his personal example, taught us how to live only on his direction without interference of even Gaudiya Math. We are a healthy branch of Gaudiya Math, but we have come out from them. You can't mix up that. Every aspect of spreading the potency has to be seen, you know. Phalena parichiyate, Prabhupada says, look, it's spreading throughout the world. And that was the forecast also there. Mayapur is also being forecasted already. So we are supposed to fulfill the desires of our predecessors and childhoods. You got everything?
Thank you.
Can you show them? By the way, this was also somehow or another I'm getting involved in. Since 1974, how many years back? 50 years back. Srila Prabhupada desired, that there should be a temple in Thailand. There should be an ISKCON presentation, which took time. We have 11 chapters now, but no temple. So, Indian community came together to Kavichandra Maharaj, and he passed on the buck to me. He said, "Vidyas, you take care." So now the whole project is coming, you know, and things are happening in their own course.
In the airport in Bangkok.
Bangkok.
The airport. They have churning of the ocean.
That's correct. They took it out now.
It out. Yeah.
You won't find them.
It had kind of like the Taiwan. I mean,
they are still worshipping Brahma, Lord Ganesh, Shiva, Durga Devi. One of the richest temples is Durga Devi temple. In Chinese to Puma. That's a business. But no preaching, they come with their faith, donate, and go. That's about it.
Sentiment.
Oh, yes. They are every meeting bills. But we are preaching, we are four devotees. I mean, Jayapadaka Maharaj, Kavichandra Maharaj is our system GPC, then Devi Narsingha Maharaj is there. He goes through Singapore all the way to China. And he has several disciples in China. Then myself, I have been going since 1997. So there's so much development is there, but most of our devotees are burning in their body. Very few times are there. I have only two Thai disciples out of 150 or something. But anyway, so since 1974, Prabhupada is desiring. In 76, Prabhupada, in 75, Prabhupada initiated one Thai lady in Paris. And Jayapadaka Maharaj, remembers her name, said, Dandamini Devi Dasi. She was the only lady disciple initiated in 1975.
From Thailand.
From Thailand. From Thailand. And her boss came. Now, the story is that Yogeshwar Prabhu is my very good godbrother, senior godbrother, and he was married to a French devotee, Jyotirmay. Both were engaged in publishing Bala books. Mm-hmm. Initial Bala books. So Yogeshwar was working in publishing unit somewhere to get more experience. At that time, this Thai lady was also in the publishing unit. And he preached her, made her devotee, and Prabhupada initiated her.
Wow.
So her boss came to see her, and he was introduced to Yogeshwar first. And he was very pleased. He said, please come to Bangkok, I will give you a big house. Start preaching. And he sent Thai silk to give to Srila Prabhupada. And Prabhupada also writes in reciprocation. But since 1974 he was doing, and all the settings were done. Yogeshwar says, who should go and stay in the house? We are with you, traveling everywhere. So yeah, you go and see, check it out, give class in the university and then meet the king. That was the premise that we are supposed to do. But somehow then nothing was done. Nothing was done. Meanwhile, people came, they minted money under the name of ISKCON, and but the mainstream preachers, we were completely bereft of. So before Corona, what? Yeah, you better see this. Before Corona, Indian community came forward, and then the thing started. I'll give you the wrap-up later. This is my guest house for Halamayana. There's a little loud music. This is the plot of land that we have negotiated, not faithfully yet. Where is the temple? That's the temple is inside. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Move the harmony also. Yeah.
Just come inside. One more time.
I'm also seeing for the first time, okay? They keep on changing, improvising and this and that, just to give the idea.
Come inside.
We have
a lot of space here. Come here and stand here. See, it's
easy.
Come on, there is a lot of space.
Both people can see
it. Yes.
The temple too. Years ago, Guru Maharaj installed New Vrindavan. I went New Vrindavan, somebody told me, oh, Guru Maharaj installed that. Oh, really? I don't know. 40 years ago. Yeah, that's a big temple, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 story. All for better base, education and culture and pavilion. Mm-hmm. We should have that kind of temple here. Right? So we should have the temple
here. Yeah, we should have one like that.
Every temple people sign outside and then disappear. This is New Vrindavan. I went a month ago.
I'm going in 2 weeks in.
Oh, you know, I told Bhakti Maharaj called me. So he's New Vrindavan.
He went to the retreat?
Yeah, like recently when Guru Maharaj would go home, temple to go home, and then he called me.
Wow.
I just said to that. Then I said, where are you, Guru Maharaj? I mean, New Vrindavan. Oh. So can I speak to Guru Maharaj? Then I give it to Guru Maharaj and talk. You see, the Gishyok. Before? Did you go before, right? Oh. I go first time.
Beautiful.
Yeah. There's a peacock I see a surprise.
Yeah.
Where peacock come? So come being from India, then now population getting more and more.
Beautiful lake there. Beautiful lake.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yes.
Very nice.
Very nice. Also it does on Prabhupada Samadhi. And then also another temple, Washington DC, before they have old temple, now they make new building. It's a very nice temple.
I heard about that,
yeah. I was there, then I saw Manu is there. I said, oh, what are you doing? I said, what are you doing here? He's living over there. So I go to Washington DC, to go Dallas. Airport name is Dallas. So airport to my niece's house, just 5-10 minute drive.
Okay.
Yeah, so next day morning we drive 5 hours. Go highway. And we stay one night. And then following day around 2 o'clock, 7 something we already home. Then following day we go to the new temple in Washington. Then after we have good prasad, 2 o'clock, nice prasad. Then after go to White House, see around a couple hours, very close White House.
So that's the design now, right? Yeah. The design, the temple?
Yeah. Yeah.
Beautiful.
How am I in Jaipur? They put in the whole, and I have negotiated for the jhankas and the balconies and the POV. I have a design, I'm in charge of GRE structure manufacturing.